selambat itu gerakan.
Itu dia detect dua orang. Okay, sebenarnya dah boleh klik dekat.
Okay, klik sekarang eh.
Thank you.
Alhamdulillah. How are you?
Khair, alhamdulillah. You are in mahal in office.
Office, yes.
Ibn Faris.
Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Can everyone hear my voice?
Alhamdulillah.
Yes, clear.
Okay, so bismillah. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin, sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Director of Selfed, Dr. Rosnani Kasim, Deputy Director, Head of Divisions, Head of Departments, Fellow Lecturers and Teachers, all campuses Gombak and Pago, and dear students. Welcome, ahlan wa marhaban, to Selfed webinar series number 8, entitled Learning Arabic for Beginners, A Smart Approach. My name is Nurul Husna binti Muhammad Taufik, from QLT Selfed Gombak, and I will be your moderator for today's webinar. InshaAllah, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, before we start the webinar, please be reminded to sign your attendance via the ISN link, which will be shared in the YouTube comment section. Okay, this webinar, inshaAllah, will be delivered by our respectable speaker for today, Ustazah Datin Sabariah Bakri from QLD Selfed Gombak. Before we start, let me introduce briefly about our speaker. Ustazah Datin Sabariah Binti Bakri holds a degree in Arabic language and literature honored from IIUM. She joined IIUM in 1999 as a Selfed teacher, and for the past 22 years, she has held several administrative positions and currently active working as project leader and chairperson for Selfed CSR. She also has been awarded by the university as best teacher in 2015, as well as Murabbi Award in 2020. Currently, Ustazah Datin Sabariah teaches Arabic in the Quranic Language Department at the Center for Foundation Studies at IIUM Gombak, with her life goal as to share happiness with others for the sake of Allah. I'm so delighted to listen to her sharing for this afternoon. And without further ado, I'm glad to welcome Ustazah Datin Sabaria Binti Bakri, who will present to us Learning Arabic for Beginners, a Smart Approach. InsyaAllah, falyatafadhal.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي جعل هذا اليوم عافية وجاء بالشمس من مطلعها. اللهم ارزقنا خير هذا اليوم وارفع عنا شره. اللهم نور قلبنا بنور هدايتك كما نورت الأرض بنور شمسك أبدا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الحمد لله. Thank you very much sister أستاذة الجميلة نور الحسنى بتوفيق. Before we move on, I think it is necessary for everyone to have more blessing, yeah, because today is Ramadan and then Yawmul Jumu'ah, and after that we hope that our fasting will be accepted by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. I would like to request everyone, we recite Al-Fatiha together wholeheartedly to get blessing from him. Al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Okay, for information, today actually is DAC meeting. So I understand that most of important person of VIPs are not here. By the way, I always thank you to them. And without their support, I will not be here with everyone today. Okay, for information, actually this webinar is my first attempt to share my knowledge, my humble experience with everyone. Once Ustazah Husna said that khibrati, my experience was about is about 22 years. I feel I am old now. Yeah, ana ajuz al-an. Actually, the audience should be students for level one or for beginners. But surprisingly, I'm looking now at the names. I found that most of you are my cliques. So ana ya'ani ash'uru bil farah wa surur. I'm happy but a bit nervous because I think what I'm going to share with you is actually what you got already, you know? And I hope there will be students here to listen to me, because I'm going to membebel with them, you know, not membebel in terms like mak-mak, yeah, Fazina, but at least I want them to get something from my sharing, because actually the original objective this webinar is for them, for students. By the way, no problem. Alhamdulillah, thank you very much. I'm so happy to, very glad to share with you today. Because when Ustazah Husna said I was Murabbi, yeah, last 2020 last year, maybe some lecturers will say, why Ustazah Raja Munirah is not the winner or the Murabbi, or maybe Ustazah Mazidah, or maybe other person. So I'm worried that you will ask me in your hearts. But please, I hope that you can understand. This is very, what we call, subjective, okay? And because of that, I want to share my experience to all my beloved students and all students out there, but they are not here. Maybe later on they will come. And it's okay. So before I move on, I again would like to introduce our moderator today. You know, Ustazah Rusna is very energetic and motivated to be motivated today. And thank you for Ustazah Mastura. Her, and this is a good try, okay? And I hope she will inspire other person to be like her, inshallah. Not only to be a motivator or a moderator, but to be a speaker, inshallah. Okay, so don't talk much. I don't want to talk much. So I'm going to share the screen to everyone. Hal antum musta'idun insyaAllah? Are you ready? It's only one, what we call one hour. So, not much to talk about. Rabbi shrali sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli.
Eh, rasa mikrofon off ke?
Assalamualaikum. Kaifa haluka ya Zian? Lam aruka manzuf fatra.
Naam, hadihi sadiqati Amira ya Malaysia.
Marhaban sami, ana adrusu fi kuliah al-iqtisad. Hadihi sadiqati Neha.
أهلاً وسهلاً بكم. أنا من الهند وأنا أدرس في كلية العلوم الوحي. ماذا حصلتم في لغة العربية ومواضيع؟
الحمد لله. I got an E.
Me too.
Yeah, we really had a great learning session, great memories in learning the Arabic. So I think we will share some of the tips for others so that they could get a good results like us. And being very specific, I think the main part to get a good results is practice every day, because practicing every day is the key to success. And start with the unknown words. I will say start with the unknown words, because when you will find any unknown words, just try to focus on the meaning of that word, then write it down in your notebook. And whenever you just got your time, just memorize the words, and eventually after the end of the day, this word will make the sentence, and the sentence will make the good results. So I believe in that, and yeah, just could do that. So what's the tip you could say, Amira?
For me, I made preparations ahead. Qabla wa ba'dal qasli. I also asked for help from my friend who has took Arabic previously. How about you, Sami?
Okay, for me, the trick is making use of the learning in the class in everyday life. Suppose you learn new vocabularies every day, like library, classroom, motorcycle, bicycle, car. So you visualize them in the real life and you can recall the class memories, so that you don't have the burden to learn. You just implement it in your everyday life. So that makes the learning more fun, and you memorize them for a longer period of time. So that really helps, and you guys can implement that. How about you, Neha?
I used to actually participate in class by asking questions and making notes really helped. One
actual word about. Right, these amazing tips from us, and I believe these tricks will help everyone to get a good result. And at the end of the day, we all know that nahnu nuhibbu lughatul arabiyya.
Shukran.
Ma'a salama ila lika.
Sasa or microphone, Sasa?
Sorry. Okay. So, Alhamdulillah, congratulations to my students, Nasik, Sami, Zian, Niha, and Amira from Bangladesh, who are from India and from Malaysia. Alhamdulillah, yes, they got A, because for me, they were very smart in learning Arabic language and in their future, inshallah. Okay, I want to ask anyone here, Huna, fi hazal barnamash, maybe Akhi Ikmal, what are among tips that you heard from the short video? Very short answer. Oh, anyone can answer for me?
constantly practice.
Wow.
This makes perfect. Right.
Ahsanti, Fazalina. And one more, please. I believe most of you focus on the video. What else?
Make preparation before and after the class. Yes. Memorize words.
Masha Allah, Ahsanti. Means you are still with me. Okay. So this is how I teach in the class. I will ask my students, are you with me or are you eating or are you cooking or are you, listening to me whatsoever. Okay. So this is example only based on their experience. Okay. How to get A in Arabic language. Dah samat. Now, I want to share, this is my student effort for this semester, level one. Her name is Alia Shahmina Ahmad Rizwan. She's taking English language. She tried herself to create her own blog. And this blog actually, her first effort to use Arabic language. I told her, try to use simple language, simple sentence, and then create it with her own creativity, then she will be good in Arabic language, inshallah. So, alhamdulillah, I can encourage her to be very confident, and this is the result. Okay, so this is only example to all of you. You see? She tried her best before this, she made mistake, and after that I corrected her, and then here is the result. Alhamdulillah. Okay. Thank you. Uh-oh, that's me. Maybe she want to say something. My video when I
ada
the cafeteria.
Al-Mafa'am. Restoran ni, Saza?
Just want to share that.
Al-Mafa'am. Nazifun. Besar.
Clean.
Oh, bersih.
So, the
okay, no problem. You can watch later on. Okay, now I want to share my original
Naam.
Slides.
Naam ke sahih? Sama kan? Naam.
Alright. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This is actually the introduction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has clearly raised and mentioned the ranks of scholars and inheritors of knowledge in the Quran. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Qul hal yastawi alladhina ya'lamuna walladhina la ya'lamun. Innama yatadhakkaru ulul albab. Sadaqallahu al-azim. And those who know equal to those who do not know, none will be mindful of this except people of reason. So I would like to congratulate all of you, and I hope that students are watching this, because I want them to know that they are very good, because they want to gain knowledge, okay, time by time. Another one, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ. Remember this to all my beloved friends, my beloved students, and all of you who are watching this YouTube. Allah promise will raise up by many degrees, banyak pahala, you know. Those of you who believe, first who believe, and those who have been given knowledge. And he is fully aware of what you do. So alhamdulillah, today is Ramadan, and then al-yawm al-rabi', okay, the fourth day. Apa dia Fazlina? Al-yawm al-rabi'. Can you repeat the word? Al-yawm al-rabi'.
Al-yawm
al-rabi'.
Al-rabi'.
Masya Allah, you are Arabic.
Arabian. Alhamdulillah. Thank you very much. So once you attend the what we call this is like halaqah, okay, halaqah ataupun tazkirah ke, I don't know lah, but at least the program which enhance our knowledge. So Allah will raise up all of you and including me. Allahumma amin, insyaAllah. And then what we are talking about is related to Arabic language, because my focus, as I mentioned earlier, I want to encourage all students who maybe as a beginner, you know, and then for all level one students, you know, to appreciate what they are learning, because that language is Quranic language. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Inna ja'alnahu Qur'anan Arabiyyan la'allakum ta'qilun. Sadaqallahul azim. Certainly, we have made it a Quran in Arabic, so perhaps you will understand. There are many things related to Arabic language, okay? So there's listening and then talking and then writing, reading and extra. And surely when you recite Al-Quran, you want to know whether this is a verb, whether this is noun, is it gerund whatsoever. Alasa kazalik, ya ikhwah wa akhawat. All right. After that, I want to talk a bit about the importance of Arabic language, because you want to connect why you want to be smart in learning Arabic language. You should know that, but before that, you must understand clearly the importance of Arabic language. But for this part, I will not talk too much because I think you know better, okay? For the first one, Quranic language is Quranic. Al-Lughah Al-Arabiyyah is Quranic language. Yeah, Al-Lughah Al-Arabiyyah ya lughatul Quran. Okay, so Surah Ar-Ra'du is example. Same as what I have mentioned just now, that Quran use Arabic language. Masya Allah. So you are very lucky to learn this lughatul Quran, lughatul Jannah, and then you know that this is a world language. And if I'm not mistaken, the ranking now is number 6 or maybe number 5 like that. So you are very, we have to be very honored. Nadrusu wa natakallam bil-lugha al-arabiyyah fi kulli makan. So I hope this one can enhance motivation to students that they must learn Arabic language and they have to be happy to learn this world language, inshallah. After that, this Arabic language actually can build their career, okay? Can build their career. You mungkin yabda min al-mustawa al-awwal, but from level one, if they are interested, so they can learn more, for example, in speaking, and then they will take any special classes whatsoever to be translator or doing business and as a motivator and extra. And antum ta'rifuna fi Malaysia, in Malaysia, hunaka at-tujar min biladin arabiyyah, okay, merchants from they need us, okay, to translate some items, some maybe for letters, formal letters and extra. Masha'Allah, Masha'Allah, Arabic language is very crucial and important nowadays, okay. And after that, in short, that's about special and unique of this Arabic language, that we should understand the standard of this Arabic language known, because that is among the earliest language fi dunya. Okay, fi dunya means in the world. All right, so this is one mazakul, salah satu bahan ataupun bahan bacaan yang for me it is related to our nation now, written by Dr. Muhammad Sabri Sahrir. He was a SELPET staff last time, but now he is working in education, if I'm mistaken. Alhamdulillah, so I took this just to share the importance of menguasai, okay, of learning Arabic language, not only for communication, but actually that is for ibadah, okay? Maybe some of you read like this doa, ya.
Allahumma ghafirli wali walidayya warhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. That one for one person, you know. Ya Allah, ampunkanlah dosaku. And then after you learn Arab language, you know how to change. Yeah, from Allahumma ghafirli to Allahumma ghafir lana. Okay, because that one to everyone, for us. Allahumma ghafir lana zunubana wal walidina, and sampai the end. Okay. After that, now we can talk about smart learning. Okay. Ahlan wa sahlan for those who just enter this Zoom or YouTube. Marhaban bikum, Ramadan Karim. Okay, I'm going to share with you what is all about smart learning. Actually, I'm not a researcher, and what I share with you today is based on my experience, my observation, and based on my friends' experience as well, you know. So I hope it will still instill motivation to all of you, inshallah. Okay. Generally, smart learning is based on how advanced technologies are enabling learners to digest knowledge and skills more effectively, efficiently, and conveniently. Okay, the learner becomes a proactive leader rather than a static follower of the educational process. And actually, I took this from YouTube, from internet. But what I want to tell you, actually, based on my understanding, smart learning maybe focus more on technologies, you know. So it looks like whiteboard and duster no more important, because it's more on iPhone and extra, okay? Because that is based on technologies. By the way, when we talk about smart learning, it's based on how great you are to learn Arabic language. MashaAllah. طيب انا شخصيا اركز على هذه الاشياء. I create myself, and I'm sorry if it's not maybe not very impressive, but at least you know that what I mean is based on this lah. Okay, so based on smart, I put as a strategy. What does it mean? Strategy is kaifa at-tullab, how students prepare themselves to learn Arabic language by following their own strategy. Okay, some of them using what we call study alone, or they read books, or maybe study groups, and then they have Facebook and extra. So then strategy generally, okay? And motivation actually based on their need, means they think that Arabic language is good, so they motivate themselves to learn Arabic language. Motivation ايضا يعني يحتاج الى هذا يعني تشجيع من الاساتذه الى الطلاب. Motivation means orang kata encouragement, support from their ustaz, from their punya lecturer to students. They need motivation to learn Arabic language. Okay, what I mean by technology? Technology, when I ask my students, they will say there is printer, there's iPhone, that is WhatsApp, Padlet, and so on. So that is technology. So it will help students to learn Arabic language. For example, when I ask them to find out number 1 to number 10, then they open automatically their YouTube, and then they open many types of websites. After that, they got all those things easily. So that is technology. After that, at-tullab wa talibat yahtajuna ila al-muraja'ah. Okay, al-muraja'ah means revision. They need to revise ad-durus qabla al-fasli aw ba'da al-fasli, before class and after class. I think that this learning is not only for Arabic language, but for any languages. For any language, I believe it can be used, inshallah. Okay, if we do not revise lessons, how can we understand what is going to learn after that? That's why, based on my experience, before class, I will share maybe YouTube or maybe notes whatsoever to my students, and then students will revise. So any good student or smart student, they have revised
Alhamdulillah, I found my class is very easy and then very very active because when I ask, they can answer easily. All right. Ukhti Husna, is there at-tulab wa talibat yahdruna hadha al-barnamaj?
نعم يا أستاذة ولكن ربما في اليوتيوب أكثرهم في اليوتيوب.
أوه الحمد لله أهلا وسهلا. نيهاو كيف حال؟ كي خبر؟ So that one some language I use in my class for Bangladesh student. Okay. After that I want to talk about accuracy. Accuracy is more on ketepatan. Ketepatan here actually I relate to grammar. Okay, I relate to grammar. Maybe accuracy means other things in English. But for me, accuracy here, okay, I intend to explain to you, accuracy is grammar, which means student must follow the right one. For example, ana aqra'u al-Quran. So they cannot say, ana yaqra'u al-Quran. Or they cannot say, anta yaqra'u al-Quran. Because it belongs to a dhamir atau pronouns yang betul. Okay. Ana is I, akra'u for I. It is suitable. It must be parallel. Right? And then for huwa must be yakra'u. Must start with ya. So that is accuracy for my explanation. So inshallah it will be smart. Ala kulli hal, actually, I personally would like to request your focus more on this part, you know, to have a good, to be a good student in Arabic language, to be smart in learning Arabic language, you must have these two things, two important things here, okay? Physical preparation and then spiritual preparation. I again would like to remind everyone, just a reminder, I took this based on my experience, okay? And if I am not correct, so please correct me. First is about physical preparation. Actually, this is attitude to our teachers, okay? I want to share something, asyair. Asyair means poet. Betul ke sebutan tu poet? Fazlina, am I right? P-O-E-T.
Yes, poet.
Poets, wow. Jazakillah khairan kathira ya ukhti. This is Asy'ar Ahmad Syauqi. He said that, kadal mu'allimu ayyakuna rasula. Which means that teacher is likely, very very close, we can imagine as rasul. It doesn't mean that, oh, mu'allim tu sebagai Nabi or sebagai Rasul. No, the meaning is the position of mu'allim is great. The position of teacher is great, just like Prophet. Means how we respect Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so we have to respect mu'allim. Al-mu'allim here is teacher ataupun cikgu. You see, I hope Datin Norma can get some new vocabulary from my presentation today. Alright, and another one, adalah dia banyak bait, dia banyak baris semua tu, but this one is another one. Subhanakallahumma khaira mu'allim. Maha suci Allah, ya Allah, the best teacher. Means, he put teacher as the person that is very important in our life. Okay, can you imagine without nothing, now you know how to read and then you know how to pray and then you know how to recite dua and then you know many things. You see? So that is how great al-mu'allim. Alladhi yabni wa yunshi'u anfusan wa unqulan. Why? Alladhi means who, yabni, build. Okay? Wa yunshi'u, membentuk ourselves and our minds. Alhamdulillah. So thank you to our beloved teachers, our lecturers and instructors or anyone who have taught us even one word. Please bear in our mind that you are here because the help of teacher. Okay? akhrajta hadha al-aqla min zulumatihi. Means teacher mengeluarkan kita, okay, pull out all of us from kegelapan. From kegelapan. So teacher give nur to all of us. Alhamdulillah. Can you see my nur in this Zoom or in YouTube? I hope so. And I believe all of you got the nur already. Ukhti Husna, law samahti, kam adad al-musharikin wal-musharikin?
Adad al-musharikin fi al-YouTube, salasa wa salasun. Wahuna fi Zoom, salasa wa salasun aydan. Takriban situn.
Situn lah, alhamdulillah. Kalau gitu, I need to baca this what we call pantun lah. Walaupun tak berapa best, tapi I want to share juga. Hari ini hari Jumaat, teringin pula nak makan duku. Degup jantungku semakin cepat, tak sangka ramai juga peminatku. Ewah. Is it okay, Cik Usna, my pantun?
Nah, very okay.
Allah khabar, okay. So now, another thing I want to share with you is about the ethic of Imam Ash-Shafi'i, how he treats his teacher, and I believe all of us know who is Al-Imam Ash-Shafi'i. Okay, there are many things, but I just choose Hadhi Ash-Shafi'i, yani respect teachers even in disagreements. Nahnu nafham yani fil fasli, in the classroom, okay, al-fasla means classroom, okay. Some students, they disagree with their ustaz or ustazah. So in this matter, some lecturers are really stressed because some students, they want to know the answer and then macam nak paksa-paksa pula, force them to answer the questions. So that one is very irrespect or non-respect teachers. Actually, according to Imam Ash-Shafi'i, we still can argue with our lecturer, but must respect, you know. We can argue respectfully. After that, we have to be humble. Okay, imagine that all of you are my students. So if we are facing our lecturer, we must be humble, say assalamualaikum, hi, how do you do? Show your respect. Even she is a Chinese or he is Indian, you know. So don't think that if she or he is non-Muslim or I should not respect him or her. So you are wrong. Okay, you are wrong. For information, anyone who teach us for good thing, so she or he is our teacher. So please be humble to him or her. After that, please show empathy when interacting with teacher. You at least know your teacher's background, maybe how many kids they have, or what time you want to WhatsApp or whatsoever. So you must understand that lecturer also have their own time for rest, for sleeping, for cooking, and then for nak tidurkan anak whatsoever. Okay, so please show empathy to them and don't add their tension. Okay, how? So you have to fulfill the obligation. For example, uktubu al-wajib al-manzili fi asra'i waqtin. You must finish your homework on time. Okay, so far, is it okay for you? Very clear, right? And after that, I want to share, according to, I need to read this from Imam Ash-Shafi'i. Okay, just now we talk about respect teachers even in disagreement. What did he say? Ma nazartu ahadan qat illa ahbabtu ayuwaffaqa wa yusaddada wa yu'ana wa yakuna alayhi ri'ayatun min Allah wa hifzun wa hifzun wa ma nazartu ahadan illa wa lam ubali bayyana Allahu al-haqqa ala lisani aw lisani. What does it mean? I never debated anyone except that I would love for him to be successful, directed, aided, and for him to be under the care of Allah and his protection. And I never debated with anyone, but that I did not mind whether Allah has put the truth on my tongue or his tongue. MashaAllah. So in short, you may ask teacher respectfully. Right. And one more thing. I found that some of my students said that her or his lecturer are orang kata like lion and then strict and so on, okay? Not only Arabic language lah, I mean other subjects, okay? When I talk about language, so kita faham sendiri lah, you know? Maybe Tilawa, maybe English, and maybe BM, Bahasa Melayu. So what Imam Ash-Shafi'i said, okay, remember all students over there? Isbir ala murril jafa min muallimin fa inna rusubal ilmi fi nafarati. Be patient with the bitter harshness, strictness of a teacher, for the stores of knowledge are present in his harshness. Okay, I hope you understand that. All right, after that, we need to have a spiritual preparation. Okay, pray for teacher. I want to ask everyone, how many times you pray for your ustaz or your ustaza, even yourself pun, sometimes you don't pray. What I mean, after prayer, ya, usna ya, lepas sembahyang terus bangun, ya, amin pun tidak, terus keluar. So, I hope this spiritual preparation must be in our mind from now, okay? We try our best to berdoa, remember our teacher. First, we pray for ourselves. Kita doa for ourselves. Rabbil fili. Am I right? After that, we pray for our parents. Wali wali daya. And after that, you can put teacher. Okay? I mean, among the important persons in our life. Or maybe you can say your family members first, your anak-anak and so on. Then followed by our teacher. Okay, I hope after this, you must remember last time when you were in secondary school or in primary school, they taught you a lot of things. Okay, tentang adab, tentang manner, belajar rajin-rajin, you know, be good boy and then be good girl, jadi anak soleh-solehah. You know, time, masa dah berlalu. But don't forget to pray for your ustaz, your ustaza and your teacher. Thank you very much for your kindness to remember them in your dua. And for those teacher who passed away already, make sure we do something for him or for them. Let's say wakaf in the mosque or in musalla or anything for good things, you know. And you mention your intention to for him or for her. Insha'Allah, she or he will be rewarded. And then at the same time, you also will gain a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, you need to ask their blessing. To all students out there, don't wait for final exam, you know, or for to get good marks. Then you ask our blessing, teacher's blessing. So please take this as important notice, okay, that we need to ask their blessing, same as you need blessing from your parents, okay? And keep in touch. What does it mean, keep in touch? Here means you always connect with them, at least during Hari Raya. Yeah, everyone is busy, you know, and then even your ustaz or your ustaza, but at least ask about him or her in suitable occasions. So this thing for me is very good to instill the spiritual preparation to be always good and to be smart. All right, so when we combine together the spiritual and physical, it will be balanced, inshallah. Okay, actually, there will be many things to talk about, but what can I say? Spiritual only is not enough. Okay, let's say you have motivation and then you come to class on time and then you respect your teacher and so on, but you do not dua for them. So it is not balanced. It will be imbalanced. Okay. We must all together, we must remember how they sacrificed for us, even to teach us Hua. Hua means he, or maybe to teach al-fa'lu al-mudari, present tense. Okay. If we don't learn Arabic language from the beginning, you will not know. Just now we talk about doa. When I say alhamdulillahilladzi ja'ala hadzal yawm afiyah, if she, I mean your lecturer, do not teach you alhamdu is praise be to Allah, segala puji bagi Allah, you will not know. Am I right? And after that, Allahumma nawwir qalbi. What does it mean? Ya Allah, terangilah hatiku. Yeah, and for many, I can change to Allahumma nawwir qulubana. Ya Allah, berilah cahaya kepada hati-hati kami. Okay, so if you don't learn Arabic language, you will not know this. So we must combine spiritual and physical in terms of gaining the smart ataupun nak jadi handsome, nak jadi cantik, nak jadi very good, excellent. In Arabic language, okay? Because once we respect our teachers, al-muhadirun, wal-muhadirat, al-asatizah, wal-ustazat, yeah? Maka Allah will give you blessing ever forever, insyaAllah. Alright. So have a break. I want to share a few things here, very simple things. The first one is al-ibtisamah, okay? Ibtisamah is smiling. That is kalimah tayyibah biduni kalam. What does it mean? It is a good word. Good word without saying. Okay, let's say I want to relate to our online class. Imagine now you are my students. You do not open camera. So how do I feel when I teach you? It looks like I am talking to dinding. I'm talking to the wall. I'm talking to nobody. Am I right? So, if you respect us, please open the camera and smile. Li'anna al-ibtisam sadaqah. Okay? Senyuman itu adalah sedekah. And senyuman itu adalah indah. Terutama ikhlas daripada hati kita. Seperti saya, insyaAllah. Okay. So, this first one. After that, I took some important quotes from Imam Syafi'i. Knowledge is not measured by how much is memorized, but rather by how much it is acted on. So I hope everyone understand this, that al-muhadirun wal-muhadirat, al-asatizah wal-ustazat, yeah, all lecturers, all teachers, they try our best. I mean, they try their best. And same to me lah. So we try our best to give you the best. Even one word, we want you to understand. Okay? We try our best. So what should you do is, even you learn only little. Okay? Like level one, you learn al-huruf, alphabets. And then you learn how to join the letters. After that, you learn at-ta'aruf, basic sentence like, Assalamualaikum, kaifa haluka, kaifa haluki, ana maliziyun, ana maliziyatun. Even simple. But what we want you to practice. So that knowledge is important and will be very, very expensive. Okay? Dia sangat bernilai. Al-ilmu sayakun nadijan mumtazan ra'ian fi kulli makan, insyaAllah. And from Caesar Chavez, okay, real education should consist of drawing the goodness and the best out of our own students. So I believe that all English lecturer, they know how to explain this, and I know you understand this. Okay, at least generally, we should understand that education that we try to give you, because we want to share goodness to everyone, and the fruit will be from our own students. We know that our students, you are very creative. For example, you can antum taktubun al-wajib al-manzil bi wasitah Ra'i'ah, using Jamboard lah, using Google Document lah, apa lagi, banyak Google tu ya. So actually students, they are great. Okay, all of you are very excellent. Antum mumtazun wa antum mumtazat. Okay, so please prove them to us as Arabic teacher, Arabic lecturer, inshallah. And I would like to give credit to those persons actually just now who shared the video, Sister Amira from Islamic Finance, Kuliah of Economy, Sister Niha, Alhamdulillah, Bachelor of Human Sciences, yeah, minal Hindi, and Nasir Sami, I always call him Nasir Sami, ICT student, same as Zian, and Sister Alia Shahmina, who is taking English and Literature, and same to Brother Hakim bin Hamza, who help me to provide these beautiful slides. Actually, I like teaching, but when preparing slides, for sure I need assistance. Alhamdulillah, a credit for all those students. Alhamdulillah, and I pray for their success in hereafter. Amin ya rabbal alamin. So I think that's all from me. If you have anything, opinion on whatsoever, I really appreciate because I'm not good, but at least I can be with you today. I'm very delighted. Ana masrurah jiddan jamma, and I am sorry for any inconvenience because I'm still learning. And by the way, alhamdulillah, Allah SWT gave me this golden opportunity to be with you today. أعتقد هذا فقط مني يا أختي. And before I leave, I give this to أختي الأستاذة الجميلة نورul Husna. Let me share with you. It's only example, okay? Example for dua that everyone can recite. Actually, you can read in Malay or in any language, Bahasa Jawa ke, Bahasa Banjar ke, in Bangladesh language or any language, okay? At least dua for your ustaz, okay? I took this from Kitab Risalatul Mustarshidin, Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda, huwa kataba hadha du'a. So I hope everyone can read with me. Dalam hati pun boleh. Yeah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma ghafir li masyayikhina waliman allamana warhamhum wakrimhum biridwanikal azim fi maqadi sidqi indaka ya arhamar rahimin. Afwan, Allahumma ghafir li masyaikhina. Okay, so ya Allah, ampunilah guru-guru kami dan orang yang telah mengajar kami. Sayangilah mereka, muliakanlah mereka dengan keridhaan-Mu yang agung di tempat yang disenangi di sisi-Mu, wahai yang Maha Penyayang di antara penyayang. So, I think that's all from me. May Allah SWT give us the best right path, insyaAllah. And I want to read this, Ustazah Husna, ya. Ada 2 minit lagi, 3 minit lagi. I hope everyone is ready. This one is special for students. Students, lead your life with iman. Lead your life with taqwa. Lead your life with prayer. Students, remember who besides you teach you about life, teach you about experience, teach you about future. Students, love your teacher, represent your mother, represent your father who guides you to the right path. So I think I've covered major things, and don't shy to call me or to invite me for any suitable events, like a promotion. And I wish good luck to all students out there, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enrich you with good heart and make your teacher happy. I pray for your success and will be at the top, to be at the top of the world. And you have to be a great leader in the future, and not only because of Arabic language, but in all your field, inshallah. Then I would like to thank you, Salpet Webinar team, you are the best. And thank you, Maratan Ukhra, Jazakumullah Khairan, to everyone for taking time out to listen to my humble presentation. And my appreciation to my beloved head of division, Ustazah Wan Nurhana, Wan Abdullah, Ustazah Wan Nurhana, and her deputy, Al-Ustaz Wan Najmuddin, Wan Abdullah, who always support me. And not to be forgotten, again and again, to our cheerful moderator today, Ustazah Nur Husna. And I always thank you to Ustazah Raja Munira, who are my backbone, you know, for all technical things. Barakallah Fiki, and congratulations to all. So thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Insyaallah, waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Jazakillahu khairan jaza li ustazah Sabaria. If anyone has any question, we still have time left, like 7 minutes or so. I would like to open this session for any question or opinion or anything who you would like to ask to Ustazah Sabaria. If not, I would like to ask you, Ustazah. I am so inspired by how...
MashaAllah. Syukran. For attending this humble presentation.
Okay. If there's no question, I have one, Ustazah. I think... my question would be, for me as a teacher, how can I remain energetic, inspiring, and bright as you are in sharing knowledge, and how you become the magnet of attraction to students? How do you keep yourself motivated, I would say, in teaching Arabic language after 22 years? Of teaching. Yes, of course.
First of all, this is haza what we call haza min fadlillah. I always mention this praise to my students, to my beloved students out there. Haza min fadlillah. When somebody praise you, then you have to keep saying haza min fadlillah, which means this is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay. Actually, my tips is, before I go to class, I put everything outside. I mean, all bad things, all tension, all problems outside the class, even it's online classes, you know. And then second, I will feel every time I want to go class, that is money. What does it mean? Salary. That salary is amanah. That's a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I utilize that salary for good things. And I have to think positive. I don't want to be selfish. What does it mean? In front of me, there are many students. And you know, online classes, some students are daripada kampung, tak ada line, you know, ha'ula fil qura, and then line pun slow and so ever. And then we attend the class and then with muka masam. Apa masam cakap Om Putih Fazlina?
Sour face.
I don't know lah. Word by word. So how do you feel? So I always put them in my shoes. Nampak tak? Jadi apa kita rasa, what we feel if kita masuk kelas and then muka cikgu tu masam. So sebab itu saya terbalikkan. Jadi saya akan adopt this setiap kali kelas. Okay. Lepas tu, my gorgeous, dah tahu kita lapar lah, kita tak makan. So, benda tu effect tau. Effect, you know, pada awak punya excellency, you punya cara nak mengajar. So, make sure kita sudah makan, we have enough relax and so on. Okay? Sebab for me, quality of time tu penting. Yeah? You ajar lah macam mana pun, tapi kalau you tak jaga kesihatan, you don't look after your health, you kurang minum air kosong sebagainya, you akan nampak kekurangan energy. Ya, jadi ia akan menuakan kita, cewa. itu ya. And then saya selalu mengingatkan diri saya untuk senyum. Senyum ni sedekah. Dahlah kita ni tak dapat face to face, Kita jadi alasan tau. Online is online, but you have to remember, adakah kita sure bila face to face kita akan senyum? Tidak juga kan? So sebenarnya senyum itulah rahsia kebahagiaan supaya student tu rasa confident dengan kita. Okay? Rasa confident dengan kita. Dan saya bagi tahu tadi, senyum itu sedekah. Kita senyum pada benda yang berhak. Bukan kita senyum pada boyfriend ke, kepada orang kata tak orang kata waruhak. Izan al-ibtisam amamatul labina. Hazi ibadah. Hazi hiya ibadah. So itu antara tips dia. Lain kali kena jemput lagi lah untuk spesifik.
InsyaAllah. MasyaAllah. Thank you so much, Ustazah. If I was still a student. Now, of course. If I was still a student, I will absolutely love you so much. And you will be my favorite teacher lah.
Syukran Syed Syahmi. Boleh jadi I punya menantu. Nanti
dia
nak
lah sabar
dengan anak.
Just now when you recite the poem, Ustazah, I feel like you were talking to me literally as a student. Really? I feel so touched. I believe all of other as well were feeling the same thing. And alhamdulillah, we have come to the end of our webinar.
Yeah, may Allah bless you again. Us, okay, and join us among His righteous and guided servants, insyaAllah. Mama amin.
InsyaAllah. It was a pleasure to have you with us, Ustazah. Yes, so, we have... Allah ibarik fiik. So, insyaAllah, this concludes the webinar. And let us end our session. InsyaAllah, be tasbih kafarah wa suratil asr. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك والعصر ان الانسان لفي خسر الا الذين امنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. شكرا جزيلا مره اخرى.
شكرا everyone.
Selamat berpuasa. Selamat Ramadan Karim.
شكرا يا الله اكرم.
السلام عليكم
على الحضور والمشاركة.
شكرا
شكرا أختي مان.